Good morning all. In today's session, we discuss database model, those are used for database management system. Okay. So in general, database model is defined as it is a logical design and structure which is used to store a data, access a data as well as update a data in database management system. So that we can say that it is a basic logical design or structure which is used to retrieve, update and to store a data. So overall database management system, database models, those are defined or categorized into four category. First, hierarchical model. Second, network model. Third, entity relationship model. And fourth, relational model. So today we'll see first one, hierarchical model. So hierarchical model, this database model organizes a data into tree structure. The hierarchical structure or hierarchical model is a graph which is stored in a database management system. That graphical structure is in the format of tree structure. Okay. So that tree structure, a single root is there, and that single root again linked with the all data. So hierarchy starts from a root data and again it expand like tree, adding child nodes over there along with the parent nodes. So in this model, child node will only have a single parent node. So that's why it is known as a hierarchical model, graphical representation of a data in a tree structures. Okay. So this type of an information is stored into the hierarchical model. So this is an example related to this. Here, college is a root child over there. That means the overall information which is stored under the category of root. So that root name is a parent, first one and infra. The parent nodes, course, teachers, student. Then course again derived into two child nodes, theory and lab. So this type of an structure which is maintained in a hierarchical model. Okay. So the next one, network model. Second type, network model. It is an extension of hierarchical model. In this, the overall data is organized like a graph. In the hierarchical model, we are organizing the data into a tree structure. It means root, parent node and child node. But for network model, the data which is organized in a graph structure, so that we can add the more number of parent node plus single child. In a hierarchical model, there is a restriction. See, a child node having only one parent node, but for network model, in that one child node with different parent node also. Okay. So in this database model, data is more related as more relationships are established with this model. Data is more related so that particular data is easier and faster. So this database model was used to map many to many data relationships. So there is a mapping cardinality many to many. At time we can use a network model. This is the structure, or this is an example related to the network model. Here A is a root node along with two parent node B1 and B2. For C2 is a child node with two parent B1 as well as B2, which is not happened in a hierarchical model. So this we can say that it is a graph structure, so that one child with different parents also. So the next third one, relational model. So in this model, data is organized in a two-dimensional table. So
डायमेंशनल टेबल दैट मीन्स इट इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ और ऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ रोज एज वेल एज कॉलम्स. सो द ओवरऑल रिलेशनशिप
इज मेंटेन विद स्ट्रॉन्ग कॉमन फील्ड्स. So the base structure of a data in a relational model is a table structure. All the
informations those are stored in a table along with the rows, that rows are known as a records. So tables are known as a relations in a relational model. So relational model basically used to store a data in a tabular format along with the rows and columns. In that, columns are considered as attribute and rows are considered as a record. So this is a basic example related to the three relations are there. First relation,
student ID, name and age. Second one, student ID, name and teacher. And after that, those two relations again interconnected with the third relation or third table, student ID, subject ID and marks. Okay, so student ID, name and age, those are considered as an attribute. The values of that particular rows, those are known as a record. So any data which is stored in a particular structure is known as a relational model. The next last one, basic type, which is known as the entity relationship model. In this model, relationships are created by dividing object of interest into the entities and its characteristics into the attributes. In short, the entity relationship model is a graphical representation. It represents the information in the format of entity and attribute. So here, entity is considered as a living and non-living things, and attributes, those are considered as properties or behavior characteristics of an entity.
For example, suppose if you have to design a school database, then student will be considered as an entity.
And as student is considered as an entity, so behavioral characteristics are like name, age, address, mobile number, those are
considered as attributes. So living and non-living things from particular scenario, which is considered as an entity, and the characteristics, those are considered as an attribute. Okay. So as address is generated,
complex over there, so that address field we can again further divide into the pin code, street name. Okay. So entity relationship basically is a graphical representation in that we have to represent with two common parts. First one, entity, and then attribute. Entity is living and non-living thing. Attributes, those are considered as a characteristics or behavior of a particular entity. So for example, suppose here student is an entity over there, which is indicated by the rectangle, and the attributes related to that student entity indicated by the ellipse like name, address, age and ID. So this is an entity relationship model. That means we can store a data in a graphical representation. So those four basic types are introductions. Those are given in this session. We will see one by one in detail along with the examples and the rules related to the database model. Okay.